Norton versus Bitdefender. These are two of the best antiviruses out there, but you don't need both. So let's break them down, and by the end of this video, you'll know exactly which one is the better choice. The only thing I ask for is for you to drop a like and subscribe to help grow my channel. Thanks a bunch. All right, so the main criteria upon which I judge any antivirus is the ability to detect and get rid of malware. I mean, if it can't do that, what's even the point? Since Norton and Bitdefender have been around for years, I'd expect nothing less but solid all-round protection. And thankfully, they've proven this time and time again in independent testing results. For example, the latest evaluation from AV Test and IT Security Institute gave them flawless scores in protection, both against known and zero-day threats. But I want to check this myself, so I ran a home-brewed anti-malware test with 50 malicious file samples. The hardest part about this testing was actually gathering those files, but I'm not complaining. This was actually pretty fun, especially since the two antiviruses actually showed some impressive results. I first ran full system scans. It's like the main source of antivirus power, a notorious security guard that diligently checks every single corner of your device. Now, mind you, if you have a ton of files, this scan can sometimes last for hours. This is some serious stuff after all, but on my testing device, Bitdefender took about half an hour to complete the full scan. It often maxed out the CPU usage, but in the end, it managed to remove 42 malware files. Now, this was with real-time protection turned off, so I actually ran a separate test with this feature, and it blew my mind, kinda. Okay, it wasn't that dramatic, but Bitdefender antivirus caught all 50 of my malware samples in a matter of minutes, and that's really quite impressive. I almost never see flawless results in my testing, no matter the antivirus I check. And believe me, I have checked a lot of them. As for Norton antivirus software, it completed the full system scan in just 14 minutes, snatching up 45 malicious files. The real-time protection testing actually showed me the same results. So what about those 5 remaining files? I'm not worried about them, as if they ever become active threats, they'll get noticed not just by scans, but by additional Norton features as well. And Norton is so confident in their capability, they actually have a 100% virus protection promise included with each plan. So basically, no matter which one you pick, you are guaranteed to get solid protection for your device. But while investing in a high-quality antivirus is crucial, here's the thing. You don't have to dish out a ton of money for it. I have linked the best current deals in the description. Feel free to use them to get the best possible price. Yet scans aren't everything. Let's talk about the extra tools both providers have, starting with Norton. This antivirus can be used on pretty much any operating system, and it finally has an easy-to-use interface. I still have minor nightmares about their old crappy UI, so props to Norton for listening to community feedback, even if it took them like a million years. As for the features, besides the numerous malware scanning options, one of the most powerful tools here is the Smart Firewall. It monitors all incoming traffic and outgoing traffic for any suspicious activity. It's also highly customizable, so you can feel in charge if you're a tech wizard. But even the basic settings are plenty for solid protection. Then there's the heuristic analysis, which lets Norton detect previously unknown threats based on suspicious behavior patterns. It's the true embodiment of making an educated guess. Norton does tend to make a few false positives with this, but that's to be expected from such a feature, and to be fair, it's better to be safe than sorry. Another important Norton feature is email and download scanning for any malicious files. There's also phishing protection, which identifies and blocks fake websites that are out for your details and money. Norton also recently introduced Genie scam protection. This is them jumping onto the AI craze train, but in an actually kind of useful way. This expansion adds a bunch of features, such as Safe Web to detect suspicious websites, AI-powered scam assistant to provide real-time feedback on scams and suspicious offers, as well as a safe SMS tool that will alert you about suspicious texts. Oh, and I like that Norton offers a free password manager to safeguard your login information and adds a pretty good VPN for private browsing, if you get any of the Norton 360 subscriptions. I think it's nice that you can trick all the cybersecurity boxes at once this way, especially if you're just starting out. Now, if we do a quick Bitdefender review, they also offer a password manager and a VPN in a bundle with some of the plans. Though I'm still annoyed that their VPN has a daily 200 megabyte data limit. I mean, come on. It's far too little. But either way, I'm more interested in Bitdefender's anti-malware tools. For example, there's a solid firewall that adds a layer of security against unauthorized access to your device. It's not as customizable as the one Norton has, but it's just as strong. Speaking of unauthorized access, Bitdefender has microphone and webcam protection against spyware and hackers. And I also recommend using their web attack prevention, which blocks malicious sites and phishing attempts. But my favorite thing that Bitdefender has is the anti-theft feature. It lets me locate my device on Google Maps and even remotely lock or wipe it in case it gets stolen. There are many more features in the app, all designed to keep your device as safe as possible. But then there's also stuff like the digital file shredder that leaves no trace of sensitive files, or the one-click optimizer to get rid of junk and improve the performance of your device. Having said that, Bitdefender is a bit more gentle on resources when compared to Norton. I can attribute part of that to their Photon technology. It helps the app to adapt to your hardware and software configuration, and this way, it saves resources while improving speed and performance. Meanwhile, Norton can be a bit taxing on older devices, so if you have one of those, I'd recommend trying Bitdefender first. You probably noticed this yourself already, but overall, the app is very easy to get the hang of. Everything is neatly organized and explained so you won't get lost. My only gripe with this antivirus is that some of their plans are Windows only or very restrictive upon the features that you get. However, that's what makes Bitdefender so affordable. You still get all the necessary malware protection, just less of the flashy additional stuff. So if you're on a budget, Bitdefender is definitely worth a try. And if you can spare a little bit more, I'd recommend getting their full feature set with the Total Securities plan. It's going to give you the most comprehensive protection, and not just for Windows, but for Apple devices and Androids as well. Now, if we compare Norton Antivirus versus Bitdefender pricing, Norton is a bit more expensive, though you can keep it simple with their cheapest plan. However, Norton's main advantage is how extensive and customizable it is, so to reap the full benefits, I'd recommend investing in higher tier plans. These protect more devices, have more features, and offer more cloud backup space. Overall, is Norton Antivirus good? Yes. Is Bitdefender good? Also, yes. But as I said, you don't need both. So to simplify this whole Norton versus Bitdefender 2025 comparison, here's my recommendations. Bitdefender is great whether you had an antivirus before or not. It's very intuitive, affordable, offers powerful protection against malware. Meanwhile, Norton will be a great choice for experienced users and those who want to feel in charge of their security. Let me know which antivirus you end up choosing, and don't forget that you can get them a little bit cheaper through the links in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you around. We're not doing a walk-off this time, we're doing a tea drink. With ASMR sound effects. Mmm.